All of this, of course, points to the underpinnings of genetics and how they interact in the development of cancer. So I'd like to hear from all of you, actually, about what genetics are involved, if you will, in the development of stomach cancer.
So I'll start. I think, you know, one of the things that, one of the common things we think about in terms of genetics is something called a CDH1 mutation. And this is a small group of patients, but it's a, that have a high propensity, a high risk of developing gastric cancer in the future. And so often it begins with a family member that's gotten it, gastric cancer early in their life, and then they are screened by a genetic counselor and found to have this, and then subsequently their siblings and their progeny, their children are screened. And if that does occur and we find that, often they undergo surgery. Well, first, usually screening until a certain age, and then they undergo surgery with a surgeon like myself, what's called a prophylactic gastrectomy, meaning removing the stomach to prevent having gastric cancer in the future, okay? The other thing that we think about is something called familial adenomatous polyposis, FAP. That's another group of patients under CDH1 mutation that have now large polyps or that develop in the stomach that have another risk of gastric cancer being developed. And so that's usually something that between the genetic counselor, the gastroenterologist, and ultimately the surgeon removing that stomach and with the gastroenterologist screening early on to help us understand when is that right time, if it's going to be earlier.
And a number of other genetic conditions like Lynch syndrome or BRCA mutations. Mm-hmm. So if patients have family history of this kind of condition, they should discuss with their physician whether they'll be benefit from gastric cancer screening. Another, outside the genetics, we mentioned that how we're gonna select which patient we should examine. Patient that have a risk factor, like H. pylori infection or certain ethnicity coming from high incident countries, or if they have a family history of gastric cancer, even though they not fulfill criteria of hereditary syndrome, they should discuss with their physician whether they should receive a screening.